All right, so let's discuss lists and what they are in Python. So let's open up Terminal again and launch a Python 3 console. So if you do have experience with programming in other languages, let's say PHP, you know how to create an array and what an array is. For anybody else, it's a way to keep data organized and within one construct. So we're going to go ahead and define an array. And how we do that in Python is just open up and close square brackets. And then in them, we're going to have some items. And those items are going to each have their own index number within the array. So let's say we're making a list of things that I like. So I'm going to type movies, games, and of course, Python. Now, what this becomes is a list that has three indexes, and we saw earlier when we split a string apart that created one of these, and so you guys already know how to access items within this array. However, if you forgot, we're going to go ahead and do that. So basically, I can put an index of 0 and it's going to print out movies. Now, if we put that in a print statement, we're going to concatenate it. I like, and then, oh, did I just lose that? Oh, cool. All right. We're going to end it there. So let's go ahead and print this out. It says, I like movies. If we change that index number to 1, it's going to say, I like games. And if I change that to, oh, not 3. So I like Python as well. Now, what happens if one of these are a number? Let's say I replace this with a number 16. Let's say I like 16. Let's go ahead and change this index to 1 and hit enter. It can't convert the integer to a string. So what we would do is if we were trying to print, and this specifically printing out an array and then choosing an index at time of array creation or list, that's impractical and we're never going to do things that way. So what we just saw, this error message doesn't really matter. Basically, again, if you're trying to concatenate a string with an integer, it's going to freak out because it doesn't know how to do that. So that is what a list is, just a way to create a collection under one variable name. And when we discuss variables, we'll revisit this so that you guys can see what I mean. In the next video, we're going to be talking about dictionaries. And basically, these are like in JavaScript, you can create JSON objects, and that's basically what they are. So let's get into that.